สวัสดีค่ะ everyone. Today lesson is I'm going to show you how to create this lovely radish flower to go with the leaf carving that I had showed you last video. So I hope you're going to enjoy this little short technique, how beautiful and easy this flower is with a little pink and a little garnish. You will put this centerpiece into a oo or ah on your guest's impression. So let's get started.Okay, before we start, I'm gonna go ahead and slide my radish here, save for the center of my flower. This is the piece that I have left. So I'm gonna put that aside for now. to start off with our flower, you're gonna trim this into whatever size of the radish you have. I have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.Petals. To do that, you're gonna shape your the side of the radish here into a flat surface. So what you need to do is trim it. As you go down, you need to curve a little bit like that. Okay, that's one. I tear it so you can see what I'm.Saying here, 2, 3, 4, 5, because my red is quite big, so I have 6 petals. But what you try to do is don't get it even, four, because it's square. Try to get 5 or 6 if you can. Okay. You will end up something like this. See there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Just like that. You curve it down tiny bit. Okay? Now, you're gonna draw a petal shape on this section, each section here. Let's get a little closer.Start from the tip of the rim of the radish here. You're gonna draw and then drag it slimmer down, almost about 1/2 inch left from the bottom. Okay, you can't see until you trim it out, and then continue do so. Try not to draw too fat of the petals.Stay, because see how this is wide, you don't want to go all the way to the edge, so your petal might be too fat, so you try to reduce it so they match all around. Okay, if not, go ahead and carve it and then trim later. If you want it that way, it's fine, but make sure try to keep the size of the petals the same size.The longer the length of the radish determines the size of your petals, how long or how big it is. Let's see, I think I have done that. Then I'm gonna take my paring knife because it's bigger, so I can control it better. You're gonna slide a thin slide by using your index finger to guide on your piece of carving, and you thumb push it, and then your left hand, if your left hand, will kind of drag the all work together. Okay, you can wiggle a little bit here, and then as you go down, try to curve it.See there? Sometimes the cut doesn't come out fine. You can trim that later. Okay, continue. Thin slide. Continue. See, sometimes if you cut it too thick, then it won't go through. Then it's okay. You can take the knife and trim it out. I like to use the paring knife because I can control better than carving knife because it's too thin and it's too sharp and pointy. It might cut the other part of my petals that I don't want to be cut. Okay, last one. See, like this one doesn't cut, so I just run my knife a little bit. Okay. Now, this is the difficult part. I'm gonna take my other carving knife, or you can use a paring knife you like, and then insert it and cut it on the base of each section. Eventually, this piece will come out. One thing you need to know is that don't use your vegetable that's straight out from the fridge because it's gonna be too crunchy to carve, then it might break on you easily. So leave at room temperature for at least 20 to 30 minutes before carving. You see that crack? That means the piece almost come out. See there? Okay. Once the piece come out, you need to trim, reduce the squareness on the corner of each section so your flower will look nice and neat. Okay, and imperfection area, you need to trim it. And if you see one of the petals may be too large, then slightly trim the edge a little bit. Okay. Now see there, they're quite quite thick. See there, they kind of stand up. They don't bend down too much. You need to put them in the water, and if they're too thick, you run the knife and trim along the edges, thickness of the radish here. Okay. Now, this what you end up with. But now I'm gonna take my knife and kind of bend it a little bit. So my petals kind of curve. Bend with the back of the knife. Don't break it, don't force it. Just slightly bend it and hold each petals. And be sure you soak them in a water, cold water. They will start to open up a little bit. Oops, see there? I just broke it. So I need to fix this one, maybe a little shorter, but just to show you that I have broke that one. And then when you garnish, make sure you hide this piece to be on the bottom side. Okay. Then when you soak it in ice water, don't lay it down like that. You put this upside down and push it a little bit and soak it in the water. This will open up more, so your flower will become very opening and curled. Since this is too large because I'm coming to the end of the radish here, it's kind of large, so my flower piece kind of big. See there? So now let's working on our center of our flower. Let's put this aside. Okay, let's bring back our piece here that we just saved it for the center of our flower. We're going to create the center of our flower. Let's see. You're going to cut a small stem. So you're going to drag your knife and then fan it out on top like that. Okay. And then fan it out on this side. And this side to meet the cut. See, you can see it better here. Be very careful because they kind of thin, okay? Just like that. Then you're gonna cut wide at the bottom and narrow at the top. And then when you get to this part here, the neck of this section, you're gonna fan it out. So you get something like this. See there? Now, each section you're gonna cut into three triangle. See there? Can you see that? Okay. Then continue. Cut the other. So you get something like this, okay? See there? Now, you're gonna put this aside for now. If they're too thick, you can trim the top a little bit here to reduce the fatness of the pollen or the center of our flower here, okay? Now, let's bring our flower back. I have this one I cut earlier with the tip of the radish. It's kind of small. That one I show you is quite big. So this is what it should look like after you soak it in ice water here. We're gonna paint this flower and assembling our center of our flower here, so they become a lovely flower, as you see. Let me get my paint here. I have a food color in here, little yellow food color. What you need to do, you're gonna, let me trim this up a little bit here. It seems like piece is unfinished. Okay, take your straight from the bottle, a little dab of water, start the center. So they become a little bit darker, and then you drag it up so you get a light yellow, not too bright. And drag the brush up a little bit like this. It's nothing difficult with this one. And get into nick and to the corner here. The nook and corner here, kinda. Okay, a little yellow. Then you're gonna slightly paint the top portion of your center of your flower here. Okay, there it is. Now, let's put our flower here in the center like that. So this might be quite big, so I'm gonna trim it down a little bit. I think I'm cut it too big. You wanna cut it too small, otherwise they're not gonna stand up. They're gonna weld on you, or It doesn't hold the shape up. Okay. Then I'm gonna take a little small piece of toothpick, insert into the center of our flower here. See, I just trim it too much now. I hope it's gonna stay, but. I try to hide the toothpick so it doesn't show up. Then insert into the center of our flower here. Voila! You have this beautiful flower here. What do you think? Let me put this away. Our flower is finished. This is quite a simple technique and take a minute or two. If you can color any color you want here, but I like yellow. You can be red or a little edges here. You can put a color here, but I want a simple white and yellow. So I keep it as it is here. So I hope you enjoy this short little technique. I show you how to create this radish flower and put it together with our cucumber carving. The leaf carving from the last video, then you will have a perfect centerpiece for your guests or your plate or platter for this place. Thank you for watching, and you stay safe and take care. If you like my video, please subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified my next coming video. And enjoy. สวัสดีค่ะ everyone.